Hi, I'm Kate, the Total Joint Nurse Navigator here at the Surgery Center of Kansas City. Thank you for setting aside a bit of time so we can go over what is required for your surgery and give you information so you can feel prepared. We look forward to caring for you. Objectives for class. We want to set some realistic expectations of what to expect during the time at the Surgery Center of Kansas City. We want you to have a good understanding of your surgical procedure and what your surgery day will consist of, such as a clear understanding of expectations, preventative measures, physical therapy, and the discharge process, and especially caring for yourself at home. Things that need to be done to prepare for surgery. First, complete your One Medical Passport online at your earliest convenience. This is your pre-registration and medical history. The website is skkcmo.com, and just follow the pre-registration links. If you need help with this, please call me, Kate, at 816-995-3140. Next, you will need to use a special antibacterial soap for several days before your surgery. We recommend Hibiclens for 3 showers unless your surgeon has mentioned a different one, such as benzoyl peroxide is one that some of them use. Thirdly, you can prepare your home by making sure all your pathways are clear and remove any loose small rugs. Bending over to pick something up or getting into a low dresser drawer or low cabinet in the bathroom or kitchen can be a fall risk. Just move those items higher or to a countertop. If your surgery arm is your dominant arm, practice brushing your teeth, bathing, combing your hair, going to the bathroom, etc. prior to your surgery day. Things that will aid you for your self-care are handheld shower head, wet wipes, and a cheap extra sling to shower in. Next, make sure you have a caregiver picked out that can assist you with your needs. You will need someone to spend that first night with you or you with them. You may need assistance with dressing, meals, bathing, and even getting to physical therapy and appointments when those are scheduled. Have a physical therapy location in mind for when your surgeon wants to start your PT. Also, let your surgeon know if you become sick and develop any symptoms or a fever before your surgery. Lastly, check with your surgeon before having any dental work for 2 weeks prior to surgery, and no dental appointments for up to 3 months, possibly 6 months after your surgery. Your surgeon will probably have you take an antibiotic prior to any dental procedure or cleaning for the first year or two, but might possibly be for a lifetime. It depends on the protocol. Check with your surgeon for their current policy. The day of surgery, you'll want to wear an extra large, oversized shirt, such as a button-up shirt or extra baggy t-shirt, or even a large loose-fitting jacket. Your arm will be in a sling or immobilizer, and you won't be able to put that arm through the sleeve of what you wear, so something large enough to drape over that shoulder and arm. Wear a pair of tennis shoes or non-skid shoes with a fully enclosed heel. Bring a large charging cable for your phone or a book, music, tablet, etc. If you have sleep apnea, bring your CPAP machine, but you may leave it in the car. If you are spending the night here at our facility, and that will be arranged beforehand, then bring in your CPAP, toiletries, any evening medications you'll need, and even a favorite pillow if you have one. We want you to be as comfortable as possible. As mentioned earlier, you can prepare your home by making sure all your pathways are clear and remove any loose small rugs. Bending over to pick something up, like discussed, or getting into a low drawer or cabinet also can be a fall risk. Just move those items higher or to a countertop. If your surgery side is your dominant side, like discussed earlier in a different slide, practice your daily chores ahead of time. A handheld shower head or sprayer is very helpful. You should also have a good stack of pillows handy for positioning and comfort for when you rest and sleep. Also, make sure you have a stool softener and a laxative available at home if needed. To help prevent infection, make sure your house is clean and your bed linens are changed prior to your surgery. Place night lights along your pathways to help you see when you get up during the night. Prepare meals ahead of time that you can heat up easily. And also make sure you have some good ice packs or a good supply of ice. There are ice machines that circulate cold water through a pad you place on your shoulder area that can be purchased online or ask your surgeon. If you live alone, you will be required to have someone stay with you that first night after surgery. Also, please arrange in advance for someone to help you while you recover from the surgery, possibly for dressing, bathing, meal preparation, and also for the care of your pets. Please read through these preoperative instructions. We will discuss these by phone closer to your surgery. When you arrive here at the surgery center, you will go through registration first, then a nurse will help prepare you for your surgery. Your surgeon and an anesthesiologist will visit with you and answer all your questions. Your driver and/or caregiver will be involved in this process and then will be updated throughout your surgery experience. You will be having a total shoulder replacement, which is the removal of the damaged parts from the shoulder with artificial components or prosthesis. If you have any type of metal allergy, please make sure your surgeon is aware. Here are some diagrams of different kinds of shoulder replacements. For any specific questions regarding your surgery, please speak with your surgeon. Your anesthesiologist will visit with you in the preoperative area and answer all your questions. They will review your medical history and medications with you and discuss the plan for your anesthesia. Surgery can be stressful on your body, and our goal is to develop a tailored anesthetic protocol to decrease pain and minimize nausea, which will accelerate your recovery. Your anesthesia team will monitor you very closely during your surgical procedure. You will receive a combination of both general anesthesia and a peripheral nerve block for your total shoulder surgery. We will discuss this more thoroughly over the phone prior to your surgery. The goal with a nerve block is to provide maximum pain relief. The nerve block will cause a various level of muscle weakness and numbness that may affect your entire arm from shoulder to fingertips. This may feel like your arm is asleep for the duration of the block. The sensation of not having any control over your arm and hand can be alarming, but it is normal after the block and it is temporary. At the Surgery Center of Kansas City, we use a mixture of medications. One is Exparel, which lasts longer, and the second is another local anesthetic that will give you a denser block but will wear off faster. The nurses in the recovery room or on the ward may ask you to move your fingers in order to check your block is still in effect. This does not mean that they expect you to be able to move or feel. They are just checking to see if you are likely to need additional pain medicine based on how well your block is working or not. While you cannot feel your arm or hand, take special care not to inadvertently injure yourself. Be particularly careful around heat sources such as fires or radiators, or if using ice on your shoulder. You will not feel heat or cold while your block is working, so pay attention not to burn yourself or cause cold injury to the skin. Start taking your pain relief medication before the block wears off, as instructed. Do not wait until you feel pain to start taking pain relief, as it can take time to then catch up and become comfortable. The block can sometimes wear off quite suddenly, so it is important to get ahead of any potential pain. When you start to feel some tingling or pins and needles and you start to regain some movement in your fingers, your block is starting to wear off, and you should make sure that you have some pain relief on board as you will soon start to regain sensation in your shoulder after that. If you are going to sleep for the night and you have still not regained sensation in the shoulder and therefore have no pain at all, which is very common for the first night after surgery, and is a benefit as it helps you get a good night's sleep, Make sure to take pain relief before going to sleep, as it is possible that the block may wear off completely while you are asleep and you have no pain relief on board. This may cause you to wake with pain that can be difficult to then control from the starting point of having no pain medicine in your system. Normal side effects of the nerve block can include: you may feel some hoarseness, upper eyelid droop, nose congestion, and eye redness on the site of your surgery. These effects go away as the block wears off. Call me if you have any of these symptoms linger. You may feel some mild breathing discomfort. This goes away as the block wears off. If you have breathing discomfort, rest and sleep with your head and upper body resting on 2 to 3 pillows. It may also help to sit in a recliner with your upper body raised. Let your surgeon know if the breathing discomfort gets worse and is not relieved by raising your upper body. Please become familiar with this pain scale chart, as you will be asked your pain ratings throughout your surgery process. After your surgery, you will be recovering for approximately 1 to 2 hours. The nurse's focus will be ensuring that your pain is controlled and that you're tolerating food and drink. They will invite your caregiver or driver back to go over instructions, and then you will be taken to your car in a wheelchair. You will be given an incentive spirometer by your pre-op nurse for you to take home. This device helps you breathe deeply after your surgery, which will expand your lungs, helps prevent pneumonia, and improves lung function. A lot of post-op shoulder patients are hesitant to take a full deep breath, thinking that it will increase shoulder pain. So this spirometer is very important to use. Please read through these instructions and become familiar with how to use this. You will have some limitations after your total shoulder. Your surgeon doesn't want you to use your shoulder muscles at first, so no lifting, pushing, pulling, or shrugging of your operative shoulder. Physical therapy will be ordered by your surgeon, and you will be given any passive range of motion exercises to do until that therapy starts. You will be in a sling or immobilizer that you will need to wear at all times, except for when showering, dressing, or performing those range of motion exercises. These exercises are to begin when you have full feeling back in your arm and the nerve block has completely worn off. Most surgeons do not order compression socks for their total shoulder replacement patients, so being active and mobile is the number one way to help prevent blood clots. We recommend that you get up and walk every 30 to 45 minutes during your waking hours. Even a short walk is better than none. Your surgeon may also order an anticoagulant prescription or aspirin to take after your surgery. These are great tips to aid you in caring for yourself. Be sure to put an extra covering over your dressing, either like Saran wrap or press and seal, when you shower for as long as your surgeon wants you to keep that incision dry. Do not use or lift your surgical arm. You can just let it hang at your side while showering and dressing. Wear loose-fitting pants and shirts. When putting your shirt on, slide the sleeve on your surgical arm first. When removing your shirt, take it off of the non-operative arm first. Both of these techniques will allow for no movement or use of your surgical arm. You will probably be most comfortable sleeping in a recliner type position. If you do not have a recliner, using regular pillows or wedges can help you get into that same position in your bed. Bruising and swelling can be common after a total shoulder surgery. Gravity may pull that bruising and swelling clear into your hand and fingertips or down along your back. Please make sure your elbow is always at the very end of the sling and that your hand is supported and not hanging down. Ice will help with the pain and swelling, and always use a tea towel or covering, and don't put the ice directly on your skin. You may experience some warmth and mild redness at the incision site. If you experience any of these symptoms, please contact your surgeon's office. Please familiarize yourself with your sling and review these next five slides whenever needed. Remember not to use or lift your surgical arm. This is one example of a sling or immobilizer that your surgeon may use. They may place you in a regular sling, one called an ultra sling, or a slingshot. If you have any questions at all, you may call me or ask your nurse and become familiar with it before leaving our facility. Thank you. Always make sure your elbow is at the very end or back of the sling or brace, and your hand is about the same level as your elbow or slightly above. This will help keep the swelling to a minimum. If you have any questions before or after your surgery, please feel free to contact me at my desk phone number listed here, or the total joint cell phone number is 816-223-5853 for any questions or urgent needs after hours. Our whole team thanks you for choosing the Surgery Center of Kansas City for your total shoulder surgery. Thank you.